When newborns and toddlers crawl and play outside, worm infections can occur. This could be a result of ingesting polluted dirt or other foreign things. In this video, we will talk about four types of worm infection in babies, its symptoms, and ways to prevent it. But before we proceed, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. The material in this video is provided solely for educational reasons and is not intended to be taken as medical advice. Let's get started! Roundworms. Roundworm infection is a parasitic infection. This is a condition in which one organism takes up residence in the body of another creature. The worms might cause symptoms because they live and thrive inside the body. Roundworms can be found in salt water, soil, and fresh water, and are commonly transmitted to humans through pets. If a youngster swallows a roundworm egg, it will hatch into a baby worm in the intestine, or larva. Larvae can enter the bloodstream through the intestinal wall. They then go up into the neck via the lungs. Hookworms. Hookworms are parasitic worms that are small, less than 0.5 inches long, that can cause infections in the small intestine. Ancylostoma duodenal and Necator americanus are two of the most common hookworm species seen in humans. Their name comes from the teeth or hooks or cutting plates in their jaws that allow them to connect to the intestinal wall. These illnesses occur when a person comes into touch with soil that has been contaminated with human excrement. Children are particularly vulnerable since they frequently play barefoot in hazardous places. Hookworm eggs grow into larvae in the soil, which burrow through the skin of a person's foot and into the bloodstream. The larvae are carried by the blood to the lungs, where they enter the air sacs. Its symptoms are almost the same as roundworms. Pinworms or threadworms. Pinworms, sometimes known as threadworms, are worms that live in the rectum and are small, thin, and white. The female worm lays eggs in the anal area as the person sleeps. This causes itching, which spreads the eggs to the child's fingers. These eggs can be found on clothing, bedding, and toilet seats, and they can also be consumed through contaminated food and drink. Infections with pinworms are more common in newborns and toddlers. Pinworm infection is transferred through the fecal-oral route, which involves a direct or indirect transmission of infected pinworm eggs from the anus to someone's mouth, either by hand or through contaminated clothing, bedding, food, or other items. Tapeworms. Tapeworms, also known as flatworms, are parasitic worms with hooks and suckers that adhere to the intestines and breed on partially digested food. A tapeworm can be as short as a few inches or as long as 40 feet. A tapeworm that has been in the intestines for a long time can grow large enough to obstruct the appendix or other organs, causing appendicitis and other complications. Tapeworm eggs are usually transmitted to humans through food, particularly raw or undercooked meat. What are the usual symptoms when a baby is infected with worms? Worms in a bowel movement that look like earthworms. Worms coming out of the nose or mouth. Stomach pain. Coughing. Loss of appetite. Fever. Wheezing. Weight loss or failure to grow. If worms block the intestine, this may cause vomiting. Belly or abdomen that is painful, bloated, and hard. If your child exhibits any of the symptoms of a roundworm infection, contact your doctor. What are the ways to prevent worm infection in your baby? Before eating, wash, peel, and fully cook fruits and vegetables. Wash your hands with soap and water after being outside, before handling food, and after using the restroom, and teach your children to do the same. Cook until the juices run clear and the meat is no longer pink in the center. Cook the fish until it is a solid color, no longer translucent, and separates easily with a fork. To kill worm eggs, freeze meat for 24 hours before cooking. Use safe water to wash and cook all fruits and vegetables. Avoid raw and undercooked meat and seafood, as well as unpeeled raw fruits and vegetables and meals from street vendors. Drink only boiled water, bottled water, or other liquids in bottles and cans that have been boiled for at least a minute. At a restaurant, ask if the water is filtered. I truly hope you find this video helpful. If you have any questions, topics that you want us to discuss, please tell us in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.